Smith.
Love.
Yeah.
Big.
Used to have what they call a shit slam.
Gary.
Diverse.
Diversity.
Camaraderie.
Excitement.
And fun.
Teamwork.
Character.
Vowel. Size. I think Fowle's special because it's so big, and it's like six dorms put together, and you know, you have a big variety of age groups that live there, older ones, new ones, ninth graders, seniors, and I think that's what, you know, what makes Fowle interesting is having all those different grades there.
I just think that I think the people that are in Fowle Hall make it special. There's kind of a distinct person that is in Fowle Hall, and the faculty members in Fowle Hall, Coach Cubitt, the Applebaums, that, you know, they've just been here for a while. You know, you just know what you're getting when you're in Fowle Hall. For me, I was a day student for 3 years, and all the day students always were in Fowle Hall. You know, and I would just say the people make the dorm.
There's this, you know, standard that the Fowle guys have to hold. You know, we have to hold our own, keep the respect of back campus up. And I feel like the faculty in Fowle is the best on campus. Certainly when I was here with Mr. Holman, who is an unbelievably respectable and authoritative figure. Obviously, Jimbo and Lori, the Cubits, who else is here? Joe Rosinski, Dicker Bob, and Emery Moore was here, Brashatsky was here, Mr. Canteros, I can't forget him. I mean, it's just a really fun group of faculty, and they make it a very enjoyable living experience.
Well, I have to talk about my very first class of ninth graders when we first were associated with the dorm. And Mr. Applebaum became the class advisor to that class. And one of my advisees, well, is someone I will never forget, who started in that group. His name was Grant Taylor. He was president, I think, of Marshall. He skirted the edges of things. He walked that line, but he brought a lot of energy and vitality to all of our lives, and did end up with a diploma.
We kind of went full circle at Fowle, because when I first came there, we didn't have any ninth graders. All the ninth graders went elsewhere. So, but that meant that because they were in the other dorms, that meant that we got a lot of the PGs and the older kids in our dorm. And I have to say that there were, more so than now, there were PGs who were kind of here just to play sports and not really invested in the dorm and the school. So they're not that big.
And the other thing is, because Fowle has so many freshmen, has all the freshmen, seeing people enter as ninth graders, and then even if they don't stay at Fowle, seeing where, how they grow, where they evolve, the things that they choose to get involved with, where they end up by the time they're seniors is really nice. But if you don't teach ninth graders and you don't live with ninth graders, you might not get to know them until they're older.
I think that Fowle, it's so big. You know, it's 96 students, so it's pretty hard to just have it have one image, but I do think that across the years, it's probably been the dorm that's been the most challenging in terms of the guys, you know, maybe pushing the rules a bit. Okay, I would say that. Although the minute I say that, I think the same happens in other dorms, but it sort of had a reputation in some ways of that. Fowle, put all the ninth grade boys in Fowle. Finally, they had been scattered between Maine and Fowle for a while, and the class was so small you might only have 20 boarding students that we decided we really wanted to put them all together. So I think that was the first time that, you know, third floor became all ninth graders. And then since then, we've either had it on like first, second, third clusters, and it's become the ninth grade dorm. But I think it's a pretty athletic dorm.
Special because it's the dorm that all freshmen come to.
Yeah.
It's the first dorm that you see. It's the first year at Mercersburg that you experience.
Yeah. Definitely. I mean,
and the people, all the students, all the faculty.
You come and all the freshmen are thrown in together. They're experiencing the same things. And like, you just remember, like, wow, like, that was my hall freshman year. Like, you see a kid, it's like, the kid was on my hall. Like, I feel like my senior year, I still remember, like, pretty much, I think I could probably name everyone who was on my hall. Just because.
Well, it's just like I said earlier, I mean, so Fowle was my association, you know, when I was growing up. I mean, it was right across the street. I was always running in and out of Fowle. I remember Fowle when it was before it was redone. And it was not a very nice dorm at that time. But it's a lot better now. But the reason I stayed there, I just couldn't even picture myself at any other place. Coach Cubitt, who was my coach for 4 years here, was in Fowle Hall, which helped me. And you know, I just always knew I was going to be a Fowle guy for whatever reason. There's nothing I would change about Fowle Hall, other than the fact that it's now becoming a women's dormitory.
I have another moment though when I was just down the hall in the common room here on this floor, and Dave Brown, class of 06, tore me up some pop tarts from this room. It's very room. And Fat Boss, Vincent Sherrod, class of 06, was lying in bed taking a nap in his whitey tighties and saw a black man enter the room and just speared me into the door. Didn't ask any questions, just murdered me. And Dave Brown came around the corner and said, you know, told him he could go into the room and get some Pop Tarts. The boss just said, oh, went back to sleep. That was the end of that. Steph was hurting. So, he's always a good memory.
Did you end up getting any Pop Tarts? Did you get any Pop Tarts?
I did eventually.
Your Fowle memory. Getting a call from Andrew Reichardt at 1:30 in the morning because he was having many heart attacks. Having to wake up Mr. Cubitt, literally pull him out of bed after breaking into his second floor apartment and having to call 911 and the health center. And then not 5 minutes after the ambulance left, J.B. Crawford setting off the fire alarm.
That definitely thing, like that Fight Club thing was legit. Like I remember Mr. Cubitt actually like opened up the wrestling room like one night, and like everybody in Fowle just like went down there, and like we had like four or five like featured fights.
Silliness in a good way, you know, where I think people are free to be who they are, and I think that's an important thing. For boys to get together and be able to rough and tumble a little bit without getting out of control and still respecting one another, I think it has been a hallmark of the dorm. And, we're Fowle Hall, and I think it's a good legacy to have.
We'll be right back.
My name is J.J.A.Y. Glenn. I came from Mercersburg in 1961.
I'm Eric Hicks. I was in Fowle for 8 years, about 5 years ago.
My name's Mark Cuban, and I've been a Fowle Hall dorm dean for 10 years.
Had what they call a shit slam. When a kid got thrown out of school in his dormitory, everybody in the dormitory would say 10 o'clock at night or 10:15, everybody's going to open the door, yell shit, and slam the door.
I've had a lot of fun with Fowle guys. They've been a major part of my time here. And I'm going to miss them. Are we getting a little sad?